Church. Hope you're all doing well. We're on part three of our devotions talking about believing for the good. Believing for the good. Again, happy new year to every single one of you on this third day. Romans chapter 8 verse 23 says this, "And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who've been called according to his purposes." Now, following on from yesterday, as Christians, we can believe crazy things at times. The first crazy mindset that fights against this verse in Romans 8:23 is when people say, "It's not easy, therefore it must not be God's will." Now, I've traveled all over the world, from camps to conferences, young people's events to senior leaders, younger people, older people, and I've heard it said so many times, time and time again. And even in our church, people have said, it's not easy, so I'm sure it's not God's will. I'm sure God's not in it. But the Bible doesn't teach us that we serve a God of ease. He's the God of the good, and he works for us, but he's not the God of ease. Don't forget that in a perfect world, God put Adam and Eve in a garden to work. Work and ease don't always go hand in hand. One of the messages that I've heard taught that fuels this misconception is that God has two types of will for us. That there is his perfect will for your life, and then there's his permissive will. And even though I can see the common sense in this teaching, I'm not too sure and not too certain that I see the God sense in it. Let me describe it in this way. God's perfect will can be defined as living with God's best at work in your life. God is the perfect place for you to step each day, but if you step too far to the left or the right, then you step outside the perfection God planned into what he now permits for you. Much of this teaching stems from the Old Testament when the people of God cried out to God for an earthly king when God simply alone wanted to be their only king. As a result, God permitted them to have King Saul, then David. However, all the kings wreaked havoc on God's people from time to time. And maybe permissive will in our lives could be that you married the person you shouldn't have really married, or you took the job that you shouldn't have really taken, and now it's a bit unsettled and rocky. But if only we could step back into the perfect will of God, then things would be smooth and calm again. And as a result, we have many people who are now kicking themselves for stepping wrong and now striving to find that elusive, perfect will of God. Friends, the reality is this, is that God gave us a choice. And while it is true to say that God has a clear plan and purpose for each of our lives, the Bible certainly does not teach that when you do it God's way, that it will be an easy way. I actually really like Abraham's mentality when he and Lot parted company in Genesis chapter 13. Abraham said this, I'm summarizing. He said to Lot, "If you go left, I'll go right. If you go right, I'll go left." His mentality was this. His mentality was, the good of God will come out of anywhere I step as I follow God. And this year, you know, if we're not careful, we can get so caught up trying to figure out what God's perfect will is that we will fall into the trap of thinking, if it's not easy, it's not God. And I want to say that is simply not true. It's simply not true. The will of God means carrying a cross. The will of God is a journey. And like we said yesterday, sometimes it's downhill freewheeling, other times it's uphill and you are pedaling as hard as you can. To change the analogy slightly, the Bible says that God has ordained your steps. Now think about steps. Sometimes steps are uphill, sometimes they're downhill. Sometimes we step on the spot. Sometimes we step backwards. Sometimes we step to the left. Sometimes we step to the right. Sometimes we step quickly. Sometimes we step slowly. And notice this, that when God says he ordains your steps, notice it doesn't say and describe the nature of those steps. Because sometimes the steps are slow. Sometimes they are backwards. Sometimes they are to the left and to the right. Sometimes uphill, downhill, slow and fast. Hey church, I want you to know that the will of God and ease are rarely companions. Rarely are they companions. Sometimes it's not always easy. And I want to say this, that when it comes to the plans and purposes of God in your life, whether it's a challenge or you're finding it easy, remember, God is still with you because he is a good God and God works. Quote of the day is this, I'm not seeking God's perfect will. I'm simply believing for the next step. Love you, church. Have an amazing day. In Jesus' name, amen.